The killing of a sacred deer is another ridiculous, crazy brain fart of a movie from director and writer Yorgos Lanthimos, and it is honestly pretty stupid. I mean, it's really just a movie about playing a game, would you rather, or where, those games where like someone says, a robber comes in and tells you have to kill one member of your family. There's no way out of it. You have to kill one of them. Who do you kill? And that's the movie.
Giving love to the world.
How did his father die?
A surgeon never kills a patient. An anesthesiologist can kill a patient, but a surgeon never can.
First off, this movie is slow and boring, and it's so like self-aware, where it's like it's going on like everyone. The dialogue is so wooden and so unbelievable. Like no one talks like this. No one like the dialogue, this conversation these characters have, is so unbelievable. It's like I don't even think it's like heightened. It's just like everyone in this movie is autistic, and I would not be surprised if someone told me, "Hey, you know that director is autistic." I'm like, "Oh, that makes sense. That definitely makes sense because this it feels like there's like no emotion and there's no like they talk about things that no one talks about, and it's like they'll be going all of a sudden that's, oh, hey, I like your watch. And talking all about watches. And then we go, oh, hey, do you have armpit hair? Let me see your armpit hair. And like, oh, when I was a kid, I masturbated my family member because I was worried I didn't ejaculate enough when I was, as a kid. It was a big secret. Do you have a secret to tell me? I want to hear a secret too. It's like, I don't get it. Like, I understand that it's like an artsy film, but it's just. So like taking a wine glass, farting into it, smelling your farts, it's stupid. And again, like some of the other movies, is that if you actually just go with it, like it never works. You never play out the rules. Like you say this guy kind of spoil the spoilers a bit, but this guy is a heart surgeon, and one of his patients dies. And I guess this the kid of the patient, he hangs out with him and he like buys him gifts. And for a while I thought it was like, okay, were they having an inappropriate relationship? Or are they like you don't know what's going on. But then it's like at one point it just goes, okay, here's how it's going. Your son is gonna get sick, he's gonna get paralyzed, and then he'll start bleeding out of his eyes and he'll die. And the only way to stop it is to kill one of his family members. And so, kill one, or they all die. Alright, that's how it is. And life is a life. That's all you can do. Like, it would say, how does it work? Are you poisoning them? Are you a wizard? You're a wizard, aren't you? Like, yeah, I guess I'm a wizard. Well, you have to do something, or they all die. It's eye for an eye. And it's like, can I see the hair on your chest? Oh, you got a lot of hair. Like it's so stupid, and I don't get it. Because I mean, if it is just a movie about that, would you rather? And, the thought experiment of trying to like you have to kill one of your family members. Which would you do? And again, not quite spoiler, but the way that they solve it is kind of like well, I don't want to play your game, so I'm gonna do it like that. And they kind of do it like that, where like they go around the rules of the game, but while still doing it, and it's just like, but that's some of the best parts in the movie, where it's kind of like funny when like at one time he finally considers, okay, so this is really happening, and he like tries to figure out which one to kill, and he like goes to the principal of their school and asks them about the kids, and like, so if you had to say. Which one of my kids is better? Which one do you like more? And some of that stuff is the best, but that I enjoy those the most because they're so how ridiculous they are. But then with how it's solved in the end, it doesn't really matter. And I think it's kind of stupid. Like if I would have picked one member of the family member, I definitely would have killed the little girl because she was incredibly annoying, and she was with the guy, which is weird, and like. I definitely would have killed her, but I mean, it's just weird. Like every single person in it is so like kind of heartless, and but like They all, none of it feels real, and none, but it's not, like, it's not a fantasy either. Like, they treat it like everything's real. But like, I don't know why, and that, and the, I mean, I don't know why, and I say I wanted some sort of thing in the end that would be more satisfying. It was this, if the dad killed the guy that, the magic kid, or did something to the magic kid, killed the magic kid's mother, or something, but then there's just like, nope, okay, that's it, movie over. Ah, that's a movie. That's definitely a movie. I would not recommend it. I mean, it's not, it's shot well. I mean, it's acted, I don't know, it's kind of acted woodenly, but I think part of that is the direction and the dialogue. But you do get to see Nicole Kidman naked, which is, that is definitely the best part of the movie, even though they're, even though those scenes are really weird, but I guess the doctor likes to have sex with dead bodies, because, like, she just plays dead, kinda. But it's just, I don't get this director. I've seen his other films, and there's some of them are interesting, but they're all weird, and I just don't get them. Maybe it's not for me. I give it, like, a 6 out of 10. I wouldn't recommend it, but if you're looking for something weird, you may enjoy it. Though, even if you enjoy it, though, I mean, it's so long and boring that that makes, gets rid of some of the enjoyment from it. But thanks for watching. Check out other replays on my head. Subscribe to me over here. Thanks.